The FBI may not have been able to preemptively stop some of the most serious issues surrounding our country at the present time, which I will wisely avoid bringing up anything to get away from the political disputes, but they did in fact open Pandora's box on the cesspool that is men's college basketball. Players being paid, meals being taken care of, all illegal when it comes to the NCAA standards. Now, if you visit the NCAA official website, you would most likely think they are the premier opportunity to streamline thousands of kids to their dream destination, professional sports. If you read their mission statement, you just might find yourself nodding with approval as it reads, "The National Collegiate Athletic Association is a member-led organization dedicated to providing a pathway of opportunity for college athletes. Click here to learn more about our core purpose and values." I mean, come on. Cue the motivational theme music. This is an organization committed to making a young athlete's dream come true. Give me a break. In actuality, the NCAA is the most corrupt organization in all of sports. Now, earlier this week, former NBA player Jalen Rose made a bold comparison when asked about the problems surrounding men's college basketball, stating they were in fact more of a cartel than an actual organization devoted to helping young athletes. Now, sounds a bit crazy, but Jalen has a point. By definition, a cartel is defined as a group of apparently independent producers whose goal is to increase their collective profits by means of price fixing, limiting supply, and means of other restrictive practices. And I really want to stress the word restrictive because the NCAA is better at this than anybody when it comes to professional sports. Just to enlighten you on the money involved, in 2010, the NCAA and CBS Turner agreed to a 14-year, $10.8 billion deal with March Madness, which was apparently received so well, they decided to extend it through 2032 for an additional, yes, $9 billion. And let's not forget that the biggest stars of this TV show are, in fact, unpaid players stuck in a state of financial purgatory. Now, the best hope we have for these players might be in the form of boycotting March Madness. Will it cost them when it comes down to getting drafted? Perhaps. But until they fight against this money-making machine, we as the viewers will continue to make our brackets and find ourselves glued to the TV all of March. We may drive the bus, but these players can definitely take over the steering wheel much before it's too late.